Anzac Day at Kawartha College. This year, we celebrate Anzac Day in a very unique way. Due to the coronavirus, we cannot have a school assembly, attend a door service at the Shrine, or be among 95,000 people at the MCG. But, just like the Australians of the past, we will continue to celebrate, although that may look a little different this year. An example is this video, people watching the dawn service on TV, and people creating their own ceremonies at home. Although COVID-19 has changed the way we do things, we will still remember those who have served our country.
Today, we are not here to glorify war, but to remember those who have served our country during conflict or crisis. In particular, we wish to honour our Indigenous people and the many women who actively served as nurses and medical staff without much recognition. In all, 2,139 women served with the Australian Army Nursing Service, and 130 worked with the Queen Alexandra Imperial Military Nursing Service. A further 423 nurses served in hospitals in Australia. 23 of these women died in service during the war. We remember, too, the men and women who served on the home front, supplying materials and moral strength to our fighting forces, for theirs was no lesser service to Australia. On Anzac Day, we salute not only the spirit of the Anzac, but in paying tribute to them, we take the opportunity to dedicate ourselves to striving for our country as they did, and upholding their finest qualities of courage, commitment, endurance, and mateship. Anzac Day is more than a national holiday, but rather a fundamental Australian tradition. Whatever Australians or New Zealanders are doing on Anzac Day, it is more than likely that an Anzac Day service of some description is taking place. It is not merely a date or some remote campaign, but rather a spirit. It is a time to reflect on the qualities of past generations of Australians, who in hardship displayed courage, discipline, self-sacrifice, self-reliance, resourcefulness, and friendship. As the numbers of original Anzacs diminish, the Anzac spirit, which was bequeathed to us from battlefields long ago, will live on because it is a reflection of the very spirit of our nation. Our men and women of the Australian Defence Force serve in Australia and overseas to this present day, carrying on the spirit of Anzac and the legacy of the Anzacs.
Every nation around the world remembers some past event, some battle, or some defining moment of history. Our defining moment came in 1915 at Gallipoli. 105 years ago, a campaign, which if not an outright defeat, was certainly not a success. History shows that for peace-loving people, we have been a formidable force when stirred into action and also remarkably successful in the business of war. On every occasion when Australians have been called upon to protect freedom, they have done so generously, effectively, and efficiently.
The young men of Gallipoli were the first Anzacs, ordinary young Australians doing their best in a campaign of intense fierceness. The casualties were horrendous. Nearly 8,000 Australians were killed and 78,000 wounded. The campaign was a failure, and the battlefields on which it was fought symbolised the Australians' courage, determination, fighting ability, humour and mateship. The essence of Gallipoli was that in the face of adversity and potential defeat, the Australian spirit triumphed. At the conclusion of the war, 250,000 Australians from a nation of only 5 million people had been wounded and 60,000 had been killed. This meant that there was one person out of every 17 people in our population who had been injured or killed as a result of the war. In Dandenong, the war memorial where the Anzac Day service would normally take place displays the names of young soldiers who live in the area and lost their lives. Their stories continue to live on as year after year we gather on this day to tell these stories.
By coming together on Anzac Day each year, our spirit of national unity, which started on the shores of Gallipoli, is rekindled. Anzac Day reminds us that war should be avoided, but when necessary, we must stand up for our values. It requires us to reflect on our own values, our school values, and reflect on the past with pride, but also to look ahead and build on the achievement of our predecessors. As individuals and as a college, we can display the characteristics of Anzac spirit: mateship, unselfishness, courage, and tenacity. And we can enrich the Australian tradition. We pause today to acknowledge all current and former members of our Defence Forces, the brave men and women who represent our country on a daily basis. No Australian is left untouched when a member of our Defence Force is killed in action. It is difficult to comprehend the grief associated with the loss, at war, of a parent, partner, child, brother or sister. Let us ensure that we remember the families. On Anzac Day, we pay tribute to all current and former members of our Defence Forces. No matter when or where they served, we must remember to pass on the significance of the occasion and ensure that future generations are guided by the Anzac spirit in facing personal challenges ahead. And let us strive to be worthy of all those we honour today. Please take a moment, in silence, to remember those who have sacrificed their lives after the completion of the last post. Thank you very much for your time, and please remember to stay safe.